If you go to downtown Toronto, especially near the Union Station, you will see a new condo building popping up every few months. We are seeing this trend outside of downtown Toronto as well nowadays. There's a reason behind all this trend. If you missed my first condo video, please watch that first to understand what's happening in the condo market and pros and cons of investing in a condo. Hello, I'm Peter. Today, I will continue with the things you need to take into consideration when it comes to a condo purchase. The 10-day cooling off period. When you buy a newly built condo, you have the right to cancel the purchase within 10 calendar days. It's called the cooling off period. By the way, the clock on this 10-day period starts from the time you receive a copy of the fully signed purchase and sale agreement or the disclosure statement, whichever comes later. You also have the right to cancel a sales agreement within 10 days after any material change to the disclosure statement. The material change here means a significant change. If you exercise your right to cancel, the developer must refund any deposit plus any interest that may be payable. If you make a deposit, the developer must make sure that it's held in trust. A developer cannot terminate the purchase and sale agreement without the buyer's consent or a court order. Like all new home purchases, newly built condo units are covered by Ontario New Home Warranties, which is overseen by Tarion Warranty Corporation. As you might imagine, there's a lot of closing costs, deposit, land transfer taxes, HST, which you can get a rebate if you are qualified, Tarion warranty fee, CMHC insurance, legal fees, builder fees, title insurance, utility deposits, builder and educational levies. Usually, this all adds up to about 1 to 4% of the purchase price. When the condo is built and ready to be moved into, there's a period called interim occupancy where the buyer can take possession. In other words, move into the unit. During the period of interim occupancy, the buyer does not yet own the condo. They simply pay the builder an amount roughly equal to what their mortgage payment plus condo fees plus taxes. No transfer of title has yet occurred and no mortgage has been given. This is something many people not aware of when they buy condos, so take this into consideration when you purchase a condo. And as a condo dweller, you own the inside of your unit, the outside of your unit, and the land surrounding the building are owned collectively by you and all the other building residents. The general maintenance and insurance for these common elements are covered by everyone's monthly fees. A portion of your condo fees will also go into a reserve fund, which is set aside for major repair and replacement costs that occur as a building gets older. Of course, the more amenities the condo has, for example, 24-hour concierge, upscale fitness, valet parking, the more you have to pay. Also remember that the larger the unit, the higher the fees. Builders guarantee that the maintenance fees on a pre-construction unit will not increase for 1 year after your purchase. But after that, don't be surprised if they go up substantially. So you need to find out before you purchase the unit, find out exactly what the condo fees include. Some buildings include the utilities and the maintenance fees, while other buildings have the individual owners pay some of the utilities directly. Okay, before I finish this video, I just want to touch on assignment. So what is assignment? An assignment of an agreement of purchase on sale is when the original purchaser from the builder agrees to allow a new purchaser to take over the contract with the builder. The original purchaser does not have to close with the builder and does not take possession or title to the property. The new buyer takes over and completes the property purchase with the builder. Then what's the benefit? What's the advantage of assignment? There's some benefit to the seller, the assigner, or to the buyer, assignee. For sellers, the assigner does not usually have to pay the builder's closing cost and land transfer tax. And the assigner, I mean seller, does not have to pay HST rebate back to the builder. This would be payable on closing by anyone who does not intend to occupy the property or will not have it occupied by a family member. In other words, if you decided to live in the unit, or if your family member decided to live in the unit, you don't have to pay HST. Otherwise, you have to pay HST. So if the seller, assigner, was renting out the property, he would still have to pay the rebate back to the builder on closing and claim it back from the government. This can be a significant expense. The assigner avoids the carrying cost. For example, mortgage, maintenance fees, taxes, for the time between listing the property and selling the property. So these are the advantage to the seller or signer. And for the buyer, I mean the buyer of that assignment, assignee may receive a price advantage over current properties on the market. That's one advantage. And assignee will receive a brand new home, and depending on when the assignment takes place, have the ability to make finished selections. And the assignee may be able to take advantage of the deposits of the original buyer and be able to put less of a down payment on a property than he would otherwise have been able to. So these are advantages of assignment. So if you're interested in buying a condo unit, I can help you with finding the best unit for you based on market data and your personal preference and wishes. Okay, that's it for today. And if please check out my other video and my website as well. There's some good information on the website, and please hit subscribe and like button. Have a great day.